The video that you're about to watch here is just me and Sean kind of hanging out, talking, just playing Farming Simulator on my self-hosted server, so enjoy.
With Holstrand modding,
Hi.
we're going to load into our Indiana farms that I was talking about earlier and get everything all set up. Zach's in the pickup there. So I need to log into admin rights or something. How do I do that?
Honestly, I've barely played multiplayer from this side. I'll get you some money though. If
Yeah, you got
I can
5
figure.
million. How do I make myself? How do you make me an admin? Prices are low. Look at that. I got some money. All right.
There you go.
Right, we got our monies now, so do some run around. It took me forever to figure out what the lighting issue in this map was. Like, if you would run across the map as some bosses, it would, like, one part would be way dark compared to the other part. Apparently, I had a little random light that was hanging out, so I
I've done that
deleted
before.
that and got going. I
How
don't
do
know
you
where it
do
came
that?
from. What, run around?
Yeah. What mod
The
is that?
one, two, three on your top numeric keyboard, not your side keyboard, the top ones.
Oh.
Number three makes you go really fast, and your scroll, if you scroll, like move upwards, you'll go down. If you go pull back on the scroll, it'll make you go up.
See, now I don't even need a pickup.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I use this to run around and check on stuff and take pictures. If you hold your left sorry, right mouse and scroll in, like scroll up, you will zoom in and backwards will zoom out. If you press down on your scroll, it'll reset you
To ground.
to ground and to regular zoom. And zero on your top keypad is how you go back to normal speed. And number one and number two are really slow.
I've never used this before.
Yeah.
This over here is gonna be my farm where I work from. I do have placeable silos I'm gonna throw down. And this is my shop and two sheds. Because I don't want to share with Sean.
I wouldn't want to share with me either.
Yeah,
I had these Kwanzaa huts, but I was hoping that they would have animation doors, but
yeah,
they didn't, so I deleted mine. And I went with the smaller sheds. That was where I was going to store my combine, but. Oh, and this rectangular building that I have over here, right next to the house, is there's a vehicle sell point inside of it, so you can sell and edit vehicles in there.
Okay.
I got that idea from Zach. No, not Zach. I can't remember his name. Whoever released Elkhorn River Valley.
Oh yeah. So these are the silos I'm gonna end up using, working out of this farm. We'll go over to Sean's, see what's up there. Sean is gonna work out of the actual main farm on this map. Used to be the animal farm, but this is our little custom edit of the map.
Did you put animals back in or not?
I didn't know.
Like I said, I don't mess with them, but if you wanted to mess with them, that was perfectly fine. Because the only re they really, I mean, I would have kept them in the map if they were scattered around the map instead of like literally all right here with no
Right.
storage space whatsoever. So it was easier to take them out than have to move the nav meshes and stuff. So I guess I'm gonna start buying equipment.
Yeah, that's where I'm going. I'm going to the store.
Let's see. Let's get my 8020. Front hydraulics, 8520. We want some twin wheels, and we got the full option. Got that.
Trying to
And
buy stuff, and Sean keeps buying stuff.
I only bought one thing. Grab my Peterbilt here. I had it red.
You know, I've never used this 8020 until today. I drove around in it a little bit.
I like it. I think Damien's 8530 is a little nicer, but it's a little more expensive too.
Yeah.
Oh, server lag there. Alright, guys, as you can see, I still got my logo on all of them. We collaborated our mods and stuff, so my logo's still hanging out where it was before on all my stuff.
And I don't have logos on my stuff because I didn't do it. I was lazy. That's basically all it is I was lazy.
Yeah, I spent like 30 minutes one day putting 5 logos on because it's so... Oh. Do you have the game settings where you can like change growth state and stuff like that?
Yep. What do you want them on?
Put stop and go breaking. Make sure flip it from if it's make sure it's on.
Okay. There you go.
See, because if you don't have it on, you have to come to a complete stop before you can like do anything else.
Oh.
And it's really annoying.
Did you want plant growth normal, plant withering on, periodic plowing required, and 3 fertilizer states?
Yeah, that works.
Okay.
Okay.
So I am going to start out with trying to choose what to start with this tractor here.
Grab a tipper. Yeah. Man, you should have seen me wasting time the other day in my video. I accidentally sold this my baler and my baling tractor. So I bought new ones and went to pick it up. And because I didn't want to drive it all the way back to the farm at like 15 miles an hour, I'm trying to load it on the back of this trailer and it keeps falling off. I get it on there, but it keeps falling off. I spent like 10 minutes of the video trying to do that and got like 3 accidents when I was selling my grain. Oh.
So honestly, I think to start the farm, because we're each starting with 2.5 mil, it's really hard to say no to an 8420 to start my farm.
I got an 85.
Oh.
With full options.
Okay. I didn't see there's an 85. Then the 8520, because I'm going to be limited on money for a little bit. So I'll start with this, and I prefer the like look of the duals and front weight. As you can see, mine on the right is the better looking one. But it also
exactly
does have Sean's logo on it, apparently.
That's all right. Oh yeah, because you didn't.
Yeah, I did. I didn't do mine, so.
Yeah, you should have. We should have had. You should have put separate stuff in there, but that's all right. We'll just be a co-op. Oh, I'm not gonna be able to spend $80,000 on fertilizer today. Because I bought like, I rented it or leased the 1260 seed tender and filled my commodity barn here with 35,000 liters or however much it holds worth of fertilizer, and it cost me like $80,000, and I went really far into debt. But I got back out of it now. So you took full duals?
I took full duals on mine.
Grab my kins. I don't know, I would never know whether to say Kins or Kinsey.
You know, I hear people say it each way, and I guess each time.
Yeah, I normally say Kins, Kinsey, whatever.
I'm not gonna buy a grain cart. I'm gonna kind of skip on that. I'm guessing, honestly, if I really need one, I'll borrow Sean's.
Yeah.
Just
a lot of people dump straight into their trucks.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Just gonna save a little bit of money, and then I go
since
buy.
Since I'm not gonna have course play, I probably actually should just dump straight in my truck. But
yeah, if you're not using course play or hired worker, it's
yeah. And apparently, even though we were supposed to have better hired workers, they still can't run grain carts.
Well, you know, just like a real farm, the hired workers are only so smart on a real farm.
That's true. So we're gonna actually sell my kins here, guys, and just run off of my. I don't have permission to sell vehicles or tools.
Oh, let me adjust that.
Yeah, just I don't know. Have you give me there admin? Give me all the rights. Just give me all the rights.
All of the rights are on.
Oh well, I can sell vehicles and tools now. That's all that matters. All right.
Fine.
So I just wasted some money there, but it's all right. Alright.
Money you're not gonna get from me. Stay on your farm.
Yeah,
until
well,
I need
I got
your
all
help.
The crops. I got all the crops.
I know.
We do have to do some field division, though. I know which fields I want, actually. I can... The two fields that are planted right now, we can split the crop on those, though. It doesn't bother me. I want those two fields. The field where my hay shed is at. The field
okay.
next to it, to the left. And then, let's see. I want 16 and... Yeah, that's it. I want 16, 5, 6, 3, and 4 for right now.
I'll have to write it down, but yeah, that's fine.
This first video here, episode or time, isn't really going to matter, so. I really did go over my head whether or not I wanted to ask you about the seasons mod or not, because I used it a little bit, and I just wasn't sure how I felt about it.
Yeah, I used it, but I don't think I got far enough into it to fully know yet, so I didn't.
It still needs
really...
a little work. I mean, it's great. It's a great idea, but it's got its issues. I think he's gotta fix the growth states. I think because like you know they're supposed to be longer, but I planted my crop, and the next day it was already in its first growth stage, and.
Oh.
Like, it only lasted, like, 2 days in that growth stage, and then it was in the next one, so... I was a little confused, because I was going to do it, you know, like, you plant in the spring, and it stays, you know, under for a while, and then you spray in the summer, but...
You can adjust how long they are, I'm pretty sure.
I tried, and I couldn't figure it out, but that doesn't mean much. Do I need? Man, I really wish the ALO pack got converted so I could stick a front loader on my 1486.
There's a lot of stuff that still needs to be converted.
Yeah, there's just a lot of stuff that. It's like I don't remember Sean Santy, I think, and Small American said something the other day, like, we need this in FS17, and I was like, we need a lot of things in FS17.
Right.
I think I'm just going to go with a 49.5 here, with the standard wheels and a front loader for now. That's going to be my baling tractor and my bale pickup. 222 horsepower. I think that should be enough for a big baler if I wanted it. Indeed it is. We can pull the big baler with this. I did round bales in my single player, and I'm not sure if they're going to roll on that field or not, so...
Now, over on my farm, I actually do have a pretty good hay field here that I could use, or I could plow it and make a field for crops. What to do? I'll probably keep it as a hay field for a little bit. Make a little bit of money on hay, because that's not too
hard. Did you figure out how to... just prices on the hay?
I didn't, but honestly I didn't look.
I looked, and I looked, you know, because everybody says you're supposed to adjust prices in the user attributes, and I looked, and I couldn't figure it out, which again doesn't mean much, but and I looked in the XMLs, and I looked everywhere. Bale fork, the spikes.
Do either one of these magnums have a front loader attachment on them?
The 7150 does.
Ooh. But do I want to spend the extra money?
In my single player, I have a very mixed farm. It's like all sorts of different colors. I think the only thing I don't have on there is New Holland besides my baler, and that's just because I don't have a John Deere baler yet. This is a really big baler. Been using the round baler for so long because... Oh! The traffic on this map is nuts. But, guys, this first video is mostly going to be just setting up. Who knows how long it'll take.
Yeah, it's most definitely. I can't even choose what loader tractor I want to get.
And it's the longest process in the world. If you've ever played Farm Sim and, you know, modded money in or anything like that, where you don't play the game like it's actually intended to by Giants, where you start with basically nothing and work yourself up, you know that setting up your already quote-unquote established farm takes forever.
What do you know what front loader arms fit this?
The 60 is what I used, the biggest one.
I did go ahead and I sprung for the Magnum.
It's a nice tractor. It's what I have in my single player.
I could have saved the money, but I figure if I need it to use it for something else, then I have a little bit more horsepower on it.
That's why I went with this 4955. That way I can use it as a loader tractor, too. I don't know, $2 million got me quite a lot. $2.5 million got me quite a lot on my single player. I don't remember because exactly what all I bought at the beginning.
Yeah. Honestly, if you guys are doing any sort of hay work, this CSZ pack is the best.
Yeah, that's what I was joking, like I'm cheating because I'm literally too lazy to try and load all the bales by myself. Without the auto load function, because it is so stressful because they just fall off all the time.
If the bale physics in this game were a little bit better, I would probably try and use something else, but this is my go-to for loading bales or anything.
That's what I was saying too. I mean, in real life, the people that have done farm work in real life know that bales are heavy as hell and they're massive. This game, they weigh virtually nothing. As far as, you know, the game physics go,
yeah,
they weigh like nothing. If you got going fast enough with like the in-game pallet or in-game bale forks and like turn sideways, you could probably throw the bales across the map.
Oh, I'm sure.
That's how light they are.
In real life, I am a round bale person, but in this game, definitely square bales. They're just way easier.
Yeah. Depends on the map for me. I normally use round bales because that's what I see, you know, around here where I live. It's round bales everywhere in the summer. Right, I got a truck.
I think it would be better for me if if you could have adjustable bale sizes again. So you could have the right size bales.
I've heard that that it's coming out. You know, they're working on it. I know some of the balers already have them, but... Got the 40-foot Macdon. I'm already down to 1.5 million. But I've got almost everything I need, actually. Don't need a forage harvester, I got a tipper, don't need an auger anymore, grab a plow. Be great. You have the wrong ripper in here, just so you know, but that's
okay. You did say that 2720 or whatever it is.
2730, this one's a 2720, it doesn't work.
Oh.
It like is really heavy and you can only go like, you can only go 4 miles an hour with it.
They got like, there's something up with the wheels on this Magnum.
Really?
Yeah.
What's it doing?
At full speed, like the rear wheels don't move.
Oh, there's a few tractors like that. That Kinsey grain cart that I have.
Yeah.
It does that too. Gotta go grab my tractor again. The Kins does that too, and I think this 80-20 might even do it. That was something I noticed in 15 too. Not as much as I've noticed it in 17. No, they work on this 80-20, and oh, the mailbox is still there. I don't know how. There must not be collision in the middle there. But yeah, I said at the beginning of my series, I said that mailbox is gonna take so many beatings.
Oh yeah.
Cause they're right on the corner, and Giants made it now, so you can like pick up and throw. I don't get the picking up of the objects idea that they've implemented. Like,
it's so you can play basketball.
Yeah.
That's pretty much all that like, it's done.
I've seen there's a couple like hand tool stuff that you could use, but like some of it's like manure and fertilizer spreading. I'm like, who really wants to put manure down by hand?
Yeah, I get the people that want to play it classic, but I'm sure that they're not going to go that far.
Yeah. There's some cool small stuff around, though, but I like mid-sized stuff. Like the, you know, this 80-20 series and stuff like that. I like the mid-sized stuff. There's some stuff I'll go big with, but some stuff I just won't.
I use that new accelerator yesterday. It was pretty cool, actually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Too bad I can't afford it. One day I'll get there. I'll sell some bales and make some money.
Yeah, that's what I was about to do on single player, but my course play, like, I don't know, I got this Lua call stack error where it was like, I don't know, it's never done it before. It was just bailing away, and I was falling behind it, picking up bales with the Magnum, and it crashed on me like 3 times. What it would do is, like, I would be driving along, and it would glitch, and my tractor would keep going, and I would be standing there, but I couldn't move, like, I couldn't escape or anything. It was just stuck like that. So I took course play out and bailed it all by myself. Or I didn't bail it. I bailed like 4 or 5 rows, quite a bit actually, and moved on. But it's like really weird.
Yeah, I've had course play issues here too.
Because I've used it for bailing on Elkhorn River bottoms, and I didn't have that issue. So I was just really perplexed. I mean, it's not a huge deal. I like using course play, but it's not that hard to do stuff by yourself. I mean, especially if you're not doing anything anyway, just sitting here. So I'm terrible at backing in this game. But that's the physics, because you touch the little accelerator button, and you're going like 15 miles an hour.
Right.
That's why I need to get a steering wheel and pedals, but I don't want to spend $300 for farm sim.
I have like a G25, but I just don't use it for this game.
I bought a joystick, because I was gonna use that. Like, I used it for my telehandlers and stuff like that, or my loaders and stuff like that. And then I always forget to put it back here and use it. But,
of course.
It's hard to drive on the server because it's like lags a little bit, so I've been running into everything.
And this isn't a dedicated server or anything, it's just hosted off my computer, so it's nothing special. Probably a little bit more lag than you'd see on a normal dedicated server.
Plus the fact that we're recording is not helping anything either.
Yeah.
I can't imagine if I was trying to watch Netflix and do this at the same time too. Why? Because I'd have like no internet left at all.
And to start out with, I'm going to use this case. I can't even remember what it's called. I just looked at it. This case disc that acts as a plow to start with. Takes relatively low horsepower, so that's mostly what I'm looking for my current tractors.
Oh, I saw this post the other day. It was this guy was disking, but it was acting as a plow, you know?
Yeah.
And it was like, he said like some like, help, it's skipping. And I was like, well, the first problem is you're plowing with a disc. Yeah, I know the game is, some of them scripted that way, but they're not. Those of you don't farm or anything like that, most discs. I gotta fix the wheel radius on this version. I have a bad habit of fixing stuff like XML stuff in the zipped file. So whenever I send something, I normally go off the folder that's not zipped or anything like that, and forget that I've edited the XML a little bit. So the wheels radius needs to be increased on this. Oh, come on.
I don't know, around here, discs are more of a heavier tillage tool. Discs or chisel plows or something like that. So normally I do set mine up as a plow for the game, but that's just it comes down to a really personal preference of where you're at.
Yeah. Say disc around here, we mostly would disc in stocks and stuff like that, and yeah, that's about it. So I have mine's the disc that I use will be a fall tillage tool. So I'll disc in the stocks and it'll leave chopped straw on the ground, and that's all it'll do. The game will recognize it as being cultivated, but it'll look like it hasn't been.
Oh, yeah.
It'll, 'cause the chopped straw will still be on the ground. I wonder how many people got the ban hammer from Fuck today.
I don't know. I'm guessing a few.
I heard there was people reporting a bunch of the posts. I guess I saw the people were reporting posts and stuff like that. But
yeah.
I don't know. Figured we'd have a better vetting program than that, but I guess not. Oh well, not my posts that are getting reported, so it doesn't matter.
You just comment on them.
Yeah. Just comment, like, react to them.
Right. I, for some reason, parked this crooked and I don't like that.
You got a long drive back to your farm, too. Should invest in a long way.
I'll charge you fuel. I didn't want to put my farm too close to yours, so.
Yeah.
And then I kind of found this area and I wanted to have it here.
Yes, when I told you about this, I was like, I know there's quite a few patches of just grass around here, like, plenty of space for a farm if you wanted to build on here.
Yeah.
Plus, it's pretty flat, so the hay fields can be used relatively well. That was my problem with Elkhorn, it's way too hilly.
Yeah,
he's actually got it right for that area of Nebraska, but it's way too hilly for my liking. I'm actually gonna start combining this field here. So.
I've actually done pretty well on the money. I still have about 2 million left.
I have 1.3. But I'm not really sure what else I need to buy yet.
I haven't bought a combine yet, though, so that's going to take a bit.
I do have a combine.
Now, I did put this gleaner on here to run it as my combine, but I think I might start with the class and see what it's going to be to design it how I want. I think I'll start with the class. It's going to save me a little bit of money to start out with here.
Which class are you getting?
It's the one that you brought on.
It's got red wheels.
This one has wheels. Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I don't use it, because it's got red wheels. I can't figure out how to fix it. And everybody else who has that combine can't seem to figure out how to fix it.
I think it's an XML for the wheels.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. I was looking for the wheels i3D just to go change it.
Yeah. And I'll go 40 foot to start with.
Damn it. I had this great thing to read you. Oh, I wonder if it's still there. Oh, yeah, so remember that post that I put earlier about the console modders and stuff?
Yeah.
The console people? So this guy, he doesn't speak any English, commented in his native language, but his translation is, you're the asshole. I'm player of PS4 and also I have PC. I paid more than you for the game on PS4 and therefore I have the same right that you get all the mods you have. Don't be hypocritical and have a little respect, clown. I was like, speak English or go somewhere else. And the guy, this other guy got commented, console players do not have a right to get all mods. And this other guy, so you, because you paid more, you deserve more entitled much. That like made my day. I thought it was so funny that he got so upset over that. It's like, you have a PC. Why are you playing console?
Yeah, well, the thing is like some of these mods can't be brought to console because of how they're made.
That's what I had the biggest problem with, is like they seem to not, or some of them, you know, I don't want to put all of them in a bubble, but some of them seem to not understand that you know, John Deere's not going to be in on console probably ever. I mean, unless some breakout deal happens, it's just not going to happen because they're never going to make a deal with Giants. The reason that they're not in there is they don't want any competition. It's the same thing with Kloss. That's why they're not in the base game, is because they don't want any competition against them.
Yeah.
And one of the points that I made in my video was, it's not that we as PC players and, you know, modders don't want you to have this stuff. It's we can't. And as far as, you know, the people that are asking for this stuff to be made goes, you know, that doesn't even happen. Like, if a PC player posted that, it's not going to happen because modders mod for themselves, and the people that, when they release publicly, are just lucky enough to get that mod because they decided to release publicly. Or most modders don't take requests and build mods for anybody but themselves. You know, if they want something, they build it, and then they release it if they feel they want to. And people are new to the community, and, you know, it's to be expected. And
yeah, it's going to take them a little bit to learn that. Like, I myself, I definitely can't be asked to build a mod and then put my best effort into building a mod.
Yeah. No, I agree. I mean, I had people asking me for stuff, you know, just the simple stuff that I did, you know, the ad strips and stuff in 15. And I would do it. I would, you know, retexture their stuff and stuff like that. But I can guarantee you, if I wanted something textured, or if I wanted an ad strip built for myself, it would look a lot better. And it's different for, you know, your friends and stuff like that. Like, you know, when you asked me for the ad strip and stuff, I did it the best job that I could do at that point in time. Because, you know, we're friends, and that's what we should do for each other. But the people, like random people that ask you.
Yeah, I'll say about half or more of the comments on my Facebook page I don't reply to. I don't want to be mean about it.
I've stopped
some
replying.
Some of it's so simple that I don't feel I should have to reply to them. Mm-hmm. Or I'm going to come off as even more of an ass than just not replying.
Yeah, that's why I won't. We're going to have a little run in there if you stay on that. I got a hired worker going now. He's opening up the field now. You got time if you want to run that way, I think. But,
either way, I can just go this way too.
Yeah, he's just opening up the field there. The capacity on that thing is actually pretty realistic, because I said it more realistic. I'm not sure exactly how much the bin extension adds, but that combine stock holds like 14,000 liters. I think it's at 28,000, so I doubt the bin extension doubles it, but
yeah,
we're just gonna roll with it.
I sprung for the big header here for corn.
I have the John Deere 612C header, so it's 12 row header. It works. These fields aren't huge.
No.
That soybean field's pretty big though. I have the yields that I got.
But honestly, like, for the tank size and stuff, it's hard because you want it to be realistic, but you also want it to be playable too. And sometimes I found that realistic values aren't playable really.
Yeah, I definitely agree. And it depends on the thing.
Yeah.
I liked 15's XML stuff a lot better because there was like fuel usage and stuff that you could edit. And you can't do that here. It just uses, you know, the standard amount of fuel. I have all my fuel stuff set as the right amount in gallons. So like my Pete has the right amount of gallons, and my GMC has, I think it's like a 25-gallon tank or something like that. I have all that set right, but I can't, you know, the miles per gallon, you know, like that Pete should get terrible mileage, and so should that combine, but
Yeah.
they get pretty good, you know, fuel mileage.
Yeah, and I wish they would have done, you know, for the fuel usage in game, like default, low and then high.
Yeah.
I kind of don't like that they just did default and then low.
Yeah. I
Because
miss
for
soil
me,
mud
it's
too.
like, I guess this summer we're so far away a lot, but we would fill up every day just to be covered, you know.
Yeah. And you know, as far as like realistic values for grain tanks and stuff like that, you know, a harvest like this wouldn't take, you know, this would be like a full day's to harvest this field here with one combine.
Yeah.
It'll take probably 2 in-game hours if you're running, you know, it just depends, but it does not take very long to do anything in this game compared to real life stuff. I mean, it takes days and weeks to harvest, you know, fields sometimes. Because, you know, stuff breaks down and
And you can, as much as the boss wants you to, you can't go 24 hours straight like you can in this game.
That was an interesting function that the Seasons mod added, because it like raised the wages after 9 o'clock
Yeah.
and before 6 o'clock or something like that, which is pretty cool. But
Was gonna ask you, how fast did you want the game time?
I have it set at 15, right? Or it's set at 15 right now. I normally have it like 5. It doesn't really matter to me
I
because.
normally do 5 or real time depending on what I'm doing.
Because 5, I mean, because like I said, I do like to have some sense of realistic time going past. 15 is almost too fast sometimes, and real time is too slow. It just depends on what I'm doing. I mean, if I'm loading bales, though, I don't want like 4 hours to pass, and, you know,
Yeah.
well, it would, you know, something, because, you know, that would have taken me 20 minutes, in real life to load, a couple bales. And I hate how hired worker misses just this little patch there. It drives me. It's like, how do you not? It's 2 rows. I'm just running around now, see if I need to buy anything else. I'm at 1.3 million. Get a sewing machine. Can I get both of these? Yeah, I can. I'm gonna get my Great Plains. And. DB60. I'm not gonna mess the DB60 right now because that's just gonna take forever to get working, right?
And you'll have to dig it out of the ground.
Yeah, that's why I don't want to do that on camera. I'm not gonna buy any fertilizer spreaders right now because I don't have any fertilizer yet. A mower. I'm gonna get my KPS 5G. Somebody retextured this mower to a John Deere, and it's private, which is kind of sad because he just retextured it, but.
That's like all the private mod conversions at the beginning of 17.
Yeah, like you converted it. Why not? It was public before. I mean, if it was private before, that's cool. But
I converted it and now it's private.
yeah, I'm not gonna buy sprayer support. I'm not gonna buy a fuel trailer right now because I'm not gonna need it. I have that.
You know what I did
Oh,
forget to do? I just realized.
what's that?
I forgot to put a fuel trigger over on my farm.
A fuel trigger? Oh.
Yep.
I
I'll
think
just
there's.
use a trailer.
Yeah, so you can just fill up my farm or whatever, it doesn't matter to me, but I'm gonna get my fertilizer tanks placed. I set the price of these Cargill fuel or fertilizer tanks at 0 because I don't see a point in having it cost money to put this,
Yeah, I did the
fertilizer on
same
the
thing with
farm.
my grain station over there.
Yeah.
It's like you already have all the buildings and all the other infrastructure, so why are you gonna pay for that?
I had the manure tanks set at 0-2 because, you know, they're not gonna go on my farm, so I don't see why I should have to pay for them and then pay to fill out of them.
Yeah.
Alright, I got my solid manure out, or my solid fertilizer out there, so I'm gonna grab my. I'm gonna lease the Seed Express. And spend a whole shit ton of money on. Fertilizer. I didn't realize how much that costs on a day-to-day basis until I started doing YouTube, because I tried to, you know, try to limit my profanity as much as possible, so that way, you know, some 12-year-old's not watching my YouTube videos and mom walks by and I drop like 5 F-bombs in a row or something like that. I don't want that. I mean,
I have a second vlog channel too that I started a while ago. I need to pick back up again, but I had to do the same thing. It's like, I don't want to desensitize people to it, but I also want to try and keep it as audience-friendly all the way across as I can.
Yeah, because, you know, our biggest audience probably is, you know, younger kids. And
I'd say so.
Which is alright, you know. And I hope it is, because, you know, most of the, you know, if you're an adult and you're playing Farm Sim, you more than likely have some kind of farm background. So, and I want people to learn from this, and, you know, that's why I play realistic. If I didn't care or anything like that, I would be snowplowing and stuff like that just to, you know, kill time. But I want people to
learn
from this.
What are you talking about, snowplowing? I made those snow mods.
No, I'm talking about, like, the people that adjust snowplow.
Oh, yeah.
Or, you know, like, the squad and Duramax Nation. I mean, the squad's a good YouTuber. It's not my style of play, you know.
Yeah, Duramax Nation,
that kid
was talking to me on my page there.
Yeah, and then he was going around saying he was the biggest plow maker or whatever.
Yeah. After I gave him one of my models for him to script.
Yeah, talking about 13 years old.
Like, not talking down to him too much, but, you know, you did use one of my models.
Yeah, you didn't make it, you. Do you need somebody to come empty you?
I'm grabbing my truck.
Okay. And, yeah, I don't mean to demean you younger kids. I really don't. Because most of you guys are, you keep pretty quiet, but there are plenty of bad eggs out of you guys that really have kind of put a damper on the community, because, and I don't think it's any of them really mean to be obnoxious or anything like that. A lot of it is just the age factor. I mean, they don't have a understanding of the amount of time and effort it takes to do some of this stuff.
Yeah, honestly, if I'm modding for the game, I'm not playing the game.
Yeah.
That's like the best way to say it, because if I'm modding for the game, it literally takes all my game time where I could be playing the game, and I'm building or I'm scripting and testing. It's ridiculous. And then months go past and you realize that you haven't actually sat down and actually just enjoyed the game.
Yeah, I mean, because you may, like, I've played Farm Sim, and then you realize that, you know, you've maybe harvested a field or plowed a field, and the rest of the time has been jumping in and out of game.
On, yeah. Essentially.
You know, you haven't gone from start to finish of even a growing season, much less, you know, anything like that. And that's like me. I mean, like I said, just the simple stuff that I do, putting, you know, logos and, you know, editing the field planes a little bit and, you know, editing the maps and stuff like that. I spend more time jumping in and out of game just to test everything, then it's astronomical, you know, because it takes, you know, Farm Sim takes forever to load, and, you know, for such a simple game, this is so tasking on a computer, and
you did know that everything. You can just buy and rebuy stuff, right?
What do you mean?
When you're doing your scripting or your logos.
Still don't know what you mean as
So
by
if you
buy
have
and
a folder
rebuy.
open and say I'm working on my combine here
Yep.
and I'm changing something in the XML, as long as I have it open already before I start the game and I sell it in game and then rebuy it in game, each time that reloads the XML and the i3D.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's interesting. I did not know that.
Oh, yeah. So in-game time does go down some that way.
That's still, it's, you know, it's still a crazy amount of time.
Yeah, but it's still, like, when I wasn't working, it could have been my second job for how long I was sitting here doing this stuff.
Yeah. If we got paid for this, it would be great, but the problem is, you know, I was talking about Poly earlier because I was, you know, this is my way of proving that the, you know, the copyright stuff actually exists. Is Poly got in a lot of trouble. That's why all his deer models are all white now, because he got in trouble with John Deere because he was making a profit off of their model or off of their products, basically.
And the problem is it's only going to become a bigger problem because of the way companies are. Like, I was sim racing. I've been sim racing for a long time, and currently Formula One doesn't let people make their mods even, because they saw how big, you know, the gaming community was getting and where the money was going to.
Yep. And, you know, because what the thing is we can mod all we want. You know, for this stuff, I could make John Deere mods all I wanted, as long as I don't start to sell them. And that's what Poly ran into. That's why he was getting on people for releasing stuff. That's because that's how he was getting in trouble. I mean, John Deere had no idea that he was making them or even selling them until he started, you know, to make profits off of them and people started releasing them. Poly truly didn't really care that people were releasing them. The only reason he was getting on people was because he was getting in trouble, so...
Well, I wouldn't say he wouldn't care, because he did message me about some stuff.
Yeah.
He did say that he was going to try and sue me, but loophole, I knew that he sold his rights to someone else. The other person didn't do anything about it, so I was free.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just, he does say he's going to sue people, but as of yet, I haven't seen it.
No, he hasn't sued anybody. I think Wessel would be the one that would be the first to be sued, because he, like, everything he's made has been a Poly model, so...
Yeah. Wessel, that's just a whole different story there.
Yeah. I still don't know. I was talking to Mark Steves the other day, because I told you I got kicked from Farming Simulator 2017 over the post that I made making fun of some of the stupid shit that was in there. and fucked me, so... He kicked me for that, and I messaged him. I was like, hey, dude, what the hell? Why did I get kicked? And he says, no, you can't be making fun of the newer players like that. I'm like, well, most of them I don't, but some of them are just too funny not to share. And he says, yeah, I even shake my head at some of them, so I will add you back if you feel the need to join again. I was like, yeah, I kind of like to, you know, see what's going on. And at 28,000 members, it's a great way to market my page and my channel and stuff like that, so... This field's only 12 acres here, 12 point something acres, and I yielded like, or what it was. Uh, 12 and a half acres and 1,300 bushels of corn.
Looks like you need a new hired worker that doesn't skip at the end.
Yeah, that's what 1.4.4 updated, and supposedly anyway, it fixed that skipping problem.
Each time that I say update to someone, I put it in quotations. As far as this game.
Yeah, that's. I was talking about it earlier because I was talking about how my game had crashed and stuff like that. And for the fifth time, I was finally got to get recorded without issue. And I was talking about that, and I was like, yeah, Giants really pissed a lot of people off, because when 1.4 came out, there was people that they physically could not load into game.
Yeah, my game was, like, physically broken. I had no idea to fix it. Yeah, I was one of them.
Literally broken. And there was a couple other guys from FuckD that were completely out of luck.
And the worst part is, like, they have their social medias, they have their forum, but they didn't address anything anywhere. And there was hundreds of people that had this same problem.
Well,
It wasn't
yeah,
all of
it.
them, but there was hundreds of people that had this problem and they didn't address anything.
Yeah, and like me, the only problem I had was when I would load in a game, I couldn't play because it was so laggy. And when I downgraded to patch 1.3, everything worked fine again. So I just stayed on patch 1.3, and now we're just lucky that I can actually still play multiplayer in 1.3 because I still haven't figured out how to get 1.4.4.
I'm excited for Cattle and Crops just to see what it does to the farming game market.
I think it's gonna make Giants step up their game a lot because, like I said, they really pissed off a lot of people.
Yeah, well, they're gonna have to, because there'll actually be some competition then.
Yeah, I think Cattle and Crops is more licensing than they do, but the problem with Cattle and Crops is it's new. So it's gonna have, this is Giants' umpteenth game. I have no idea how many they've made so far, but I know at
Started
least
in
back to
2009 and then skip every year.
So they've what, six 11, 13, 15, and 17. So that's 5 games that they've made. This will be Cattle and Crops' first game. So naturally, it's gonna have its bugs. And
But I like who they I'll say I like who they are. From the, I don't know if you guys know this, the creators of Cattle and Crops are modders from Farming Simulator, most of them.
really, I didn't
And
know
then
that.
there's like a guy who knows Unreal Engine 4 or something like that. But a good amount of them are came from Farming Simulator. So I would say I like who they are, and they're coming at it from an open modding mindset in the beginning.
Yeah, I hear Lindbergh's pretty excited about it.
I don't care what Lindbergh says.
As much as I hate the guy, I do kind of understand where he's coming from, and that's what I was saying earlier too, is that, he may be a jerk, and I haven't been around the modding community enough, because I just really started modding. And the tail end of the 15 era, I call it. So I wasn't around in 13. I don't know what he released, and how he acted as in 13. I watched some of his videos from 2013, but they're pretty, well, he didn't talk in most of them or anything like that, so I can really tell. And my problem is with him isn't that he doesn't release mods, it's that he's just a dick.
Yeah.
It has nothing to do with the fact he doesn't release mods or I can't have his mods or anything like that, because we've
Well,
got mods for people that we know that are better.
the worst part is that that's immediately what people are gonna say each time you say that about him, but I just don't like how he treats people.
Yeah,
How
it has
him and
nothing
his
to do with,
whole group treat anyone
it
in
has
the
nothing to
community.
do with his mods or anything like that. I mean, I'm sure his mods are good, but they're not even brands that I use. His 2013 mods, yeah, he had John Deere and stuff like that and Case, but I don't really use New Holland or anything like that, which is pretty much all he has. So I'm not all that interested in his mods. It's just that he's just such a jerk to people, and it's not necessarily him so much all the time. It's his little minions that he's got going for him. That
The stuff I've even used, though, that's been leaked that is supposed to be the good stuff isn't that great, even.
Nope. And that's because I'm pretty sure most of the stuff that he has is not the same as the stuff that gets leaked or released
Yeah, I
to
wouldn't put
be. I
it
mean,
past him to put out lower versions than what he has.
if you just watch like the videos of his mod spotlights on his his 40 440 and, or R4045 and stuff like that, and his Case Patriot 4040, you can see like all the IC and stuff that's in his versions compared to the stuff that we actually have.
And he did try and cut down a good friend of mine too, so that's not that cool. When he came after Kevin.
Oh yeah,
Yeah.
I forgot about that actually.
Yeah, I wasn't too happy about that. If you guys don't know Kevin, K&M modding, he's actually a really good guy who shares pretty much everything, and
Oh
one of his
yeah.
mods got leaked that Joe got a hold of, and Joe made a pretty much a slam video on why Joe's mod was better than Kevin's,
Yeah,
and
because it was this R4045 that was not anywhere, like it wasn't even 50% done. Because those of us that were, you know, we had a dedicated server going with him and everything at this time, and we didn't even have that mod.
Yeah,
that's how not done it was. We didn't even have it.
It was very early in-game stages of the mod. And Joe just pretty much teared it apart and didn't care what anyone said when people corrected him on how it was.
Yeah, I did forget about that, but yeah, that's how early in the stage it was that, you know, his closest modding people didn't even have a hold of it yet, and so that was that's the side of Lindbergh that we don't like. That's the part that is the problem. It's not that he doesn't release his mods like everybody's gonna say. It's not that anything, because we don't
care. Do you
care.
Want this
we make
load
her,
core, or do you want me to take it?
You take it. That's fine. It doesn't matter to me. And you know, and he got burned a few times. He got burned with Wind Chaser being released early. So I do kind of understand why he doesn't always release his stuff. It's the same thing with Random Sparks. He got burned with his Lois Hills maps, and it really made him look bad as a modder when that got leaked, because it was kind of like Kevin's. It was not near finished. And that kind of
about
just made
it
him...
is, though, is like for me, I do my mods by myself, and
yep.
I test it by myself as
yep,
much as
same.
I can before I send it, even to my closest friends, because
yeah,
friends
I don't
get
have
mad
any...
at friends.
I don't have any of his stuff.
Yeah.
That he that
yeah,
is
he
not
doesn't have any of my stuff that's
public.
In beta right now. And just because of that simple fact, I want it to be as close to finish before I send it off to get beta tested. And it seems to be a hard concept for people to understand in the community to just try and finish your mods before it gets sent. I get that
yep.
you collaborate with people and you're on teams with people, but for me,
yeah.
I keep my stuff close until it's almost done.
And I don't build from scratch, and I don't build in Blender. And I could probably, actually, now that I've been looking through the scripts and stuff, I could probably end-game something if I really had the time and the patience to do it. But other than that, I just do simple, make it my own type of stuff. And in 15, you know, I released a lot of that stuff because... I had my own edits of my edit, and I released my edit of that, or of the original.
So, you know, I bet when you sell what you have in your silo, it's gonna go into my account, so I'll have to pay you then.
Yeah, or we just got to figure out the admin, right? So we're both admins.
Yeah.
But where did I put my corn or my grain header? Oh, I know where I put it. I put it away. Got my truck again. But and the problem with being on a team like you know, the Silverado that Zach and I are working on together is, you know, Zach's busy. He's got a job and he's got a family, and I got a job. I'm not old enough to have a family yet, but.
Yeah, you don't need to do that yet.
Yeah. Well. Don't be silly. Wrap your willy. But we're all busy with our own stuff, and so it's hard for to work as a team, because when I'm free, he's not necessarily free, and vice versa. You know, we're recording this at. What is it? It's 11:45 now.
Yeah, it's almost
time.
Like, I should be going to bed here soon for work tomorrow.
Yep, I
but,
probably will be.
I'm going to finish recording this first, obviously. But the thing about it is, like, it goes back to me saying earlier, if I don't want to do it by myself, I'm not going to, like, give it my full effort. And I don't want to do something if I don't feel like I can give it my full effort.
Yep.
So I can't have someone say, okay, as a group, we're going to build this mod, and if it's something I don't like, I'm not going to do my full part 100%, I don't feel like.
Yep.
It's different, you know, for work and stuff, because you're getting paid to do that, but...
Yeah.
For this.
Yeah. And this Silverado, it's going to get released. This will be our first mod as a team, and we've had some help from Eric Smith getting some scripting for it. It's not going to be the best by any means. It's going to be good. We've put a lot of hours into it. It's going to have all kinds of loads of customization options and stuff like that. And we're still, Zach's working on it now. He's getting back to his part, but he's got some bugs to get worked out with the attacher, with the attached joints.
I did get that back. I don't know if I ever told you. Yeah, I did get that. I need to test it to see, make sure it works.
But,
so the cool thing about that is, my favorite part about it is a real working drop hitch that we did.
That was, Eric helped us with that, getting, that guy's a scripting genius.
Yeah, I built it, and then I tried to script it, and I honestly don't know what I was doing. I think I missed one number, and I got Eric Smith to help me out with that. And it's, I think it's honestly really cool, because the trailers in this game, just different builders build them to different scales, so they end up different heights.
I wish there was a universal modic scale, so everything was scaled the same.
Yeah.
I say that the in-game stuff, and everybody says, oh, the in-game stuff is small. Well, it doesn't matter what the in-game stuff is small, because everything, you know, the whole world of Farm Sim is scaled to the in-game stuff. So, you know, all the objects that you're going to find that are public and stuff like that are more than likely going to be scaled to the in-game stuff. That's what I always say to the in-game stuff, but, you know, I have people that argue with me about it, which is, you know, just fine, but... Just because, you know, I'm big on scale. If stuff's not scaled right or seems scaled wrong to me, I won't use it. And I've, in 15 especially, I put some really good mods into my trash folder because the rest of my farm wasn't scaled to it. Sometimes it was too big.
It seems most of the time they're built too big, yeah.
Yep, like the pickup, like, if my pickup is double the size or the same size as my semi, I'm not going to use it.
And some of you guys might be laughing at that, but the worst part is it's actually, it happens.
Yeah.
But it's like, just different people. Me personally, when I build something, I build off real world specs for everything.
Yep. Which is close to what Giants has. I know Giants stuff is a little smaller scale than real stuff, I think, if you put it at a 1-to-1 scale. But it's pretty close, but like this pickup here is just like a hair too big, just a hair, and it's not big, too big that I won't use it, obviously, because I am you know, it's almost too big compared to this Peterbilt. I think this Pete is a little small, actually.
It does seem a little small in comparison to the trailer. And the
you should see the other Pete that I have. The other Pete that's in here, the flat top. That thing's so tiny. It's a nice mod, though, so I keep it, you know. I try to ignore the scale sometimes.
I'm just going to run over my hitch here. It's okay. I'll order a new one.
Yeah. We got money. Just kidding. We have nothing. We're poor.
Yeah, one bad farming season, we wouldn't have much money left.
Yeah, the yields that we're going to get off these are terrible because they haven't been fertilized at all. I realized that these haven't been fertilized, so that's why the money was terrible when I sold my grain on my single player. I was like, wow, that was bad.
All right.
Jesus, this guy missed a whole section. Do you want to do the headlands?
Yeah, if I can... One second.
By the way, this field really sucks if you ever use Courseplay on single player with this. I had, when I was ripping this field, I was running Courseplay because I was recording, and watching ripping is really boring. So I was off doing other things, and he ran into the river like 5 times.
I forgot that this combine lowers his header too much.
Oh, yeah, you gotta adjust the cutting height, don't you?
Yeah. That's another thing. Different attacher joints, different headers, different combines. They never all line up the same.
Yeah. These MacDons are pretty good, though. I like them.
Yeah. The combine that I wish was done just a bit better for me is the Gleaner. Just
Yeah.
because I've ran one, so I really wanted to run one in game, but
Josh didn't do a terrible job on it, but
he didn't do a terrible job. It was one of his first full mods that he'd done,
yeah.
and he's still working on it. I know that he's working on updates all the time on it.
Yeah, I really all you all of the people, not you guys, I doubt there's any of you in here that are watching my videos at least that attacked him on that. That wasn't very nice. Because I can almost guarantee you that most of the people that were saying stuff have never even opened GE, much less Blender. It's really hard. Blender scares me. Zach's got it down though. He
I
really
don't have
gets
it
it.
down. No, I don't have it down at all,
You
honestly.
get I can't even move in the thing.
I can build stuff, but it's not, I'm not happy with where I'm building stuff at. I'll say
Well,
that.
yeah, I mean, you gotta start somewhere, but it's modding is hard. I don't care what anybody says. Joe Lindbergh can say it's easy or whatever all he wants. It's hard, and it's time consuming.
Yeah, the biggest thing is time. I'll say I started modding very, very lightly in 13 probably, and then a little bit more editing and getting into stuff in 15, and towards the end of 15, started in Blender. So I didn't start like 1 month and then just bam, I'm in Blender. It was actually over years I started editing and then into Blender.
I've learned a lot pretty quick. Like I said, I started really getting into modding probably July. I think July is when I made my page of last year, so not even I haven't even been doing this really a year.
Yeah.
Because I played 13, I had it on my Xbox 360, and I liked it because it's like I grew up in agriculture, and then I got 15. And I really got bored with it because, it's like you. The problem with no mods is you can only buy so much stuff.
Yeah, and then you just end
With
up with
mods, you
the
can
same.
change everything every day. Change the scenery, change, anything. So I decided to buy a PC. And so I got my PC and I downloaded all the mods that I could, and then I realized my PC would not run all of these mods that I wanted. So I got a new graphics card, and now we're here today. I'm recording, playing on a server with super high graphics at 60 FPS, give or take.
I haven't even checked mine yet. Oh, wrong button. Yeah, actually 60.
Yeah, this they did it. I opened up 15 like a couple hours ago just because I was bored and I wanted to see what I had going in 15. And my FPS was so bad because that game was so heavy.
Yeah, people
That's
say
one
that
thing.
this game runs worse, but honestly, this game, as far as
No.
being optimized, is so much better.
It's like 1,000 times better. I don't know. It doesn't look quite as good, but see, I had like real daylight and stuff like that. And in 6 months from now, I mean, what, 15 been out 2 years, and we were really just starting to see good mods start to roll in. That 13 had been having for quite a while. I guess the mods that we were seeing towards the end of 15 would be equivalent to like the more realistic stuff that came out for 13.
Yeah, I'd say so.
And so and the textures and the within the maps that were coming out were
I'll say
beautiful
this though,
and
to this day, I still miss some of those more realistic mods
never
at the
played
end of
with them.
13.
I have 13, like I can download it on my computer and play it, but the problem is like finding all of the mods and stuff would be so overwhelming for me.
Oh yeah, and especially now there's going to be a lot of dead links and stuff.
Oh yeah. American
There's,
Eagle still has a
yeah, they would have a good amount. There
but
is still a guy that plays 13, and he'll come on Facebook.
Craft Farms?
No, someone
Ty.
else.
Say Ty plays 13 pretty religiously, but that's because he does YouTube's things for it. And he doesn't even have 17 yet, he's still on 15.
Actually, the weird thing is I'm pretty sure Tidecraft lives like in the same town as me or like next town over. And when I say next town over, like I honestly mean next town over, it's just across the river. So he like lives right around me, so it'd be cool to film something with him sometime.
He's kind of, I mean, I like him. He's nice enough. I mean, he likes all my stuff, and he actually helped me with OBS.
Because I wasn't.
Yeah, because you're busy.
You know what? I never reset my GPS with to this header.
But yeah, he helped me with my thing, and you know, I like him. He's a nice enough guy, but he's got a lot of private mods and stuff, which I don't have anything against private mods, like I said. You know, I wish I had some of the stuff that he has because he's got some really nice older stuff.
Is he, does he do stuff with Tyson?
I don't know. I mean, I watch stuff unfolds in like MAFM and USFS with those guys. And, I mean, I think he's in Canadian FM with Rory. I actually helped. I did an ad strip for Rory for 15. That was I forgot to send you screenshots of that. That was odd.
Yeah, that would be odd.
I was like, out of all the stuff that he does, you know, I don't. I guess I don't. Like I said, I don't know. All I've heard a lot of rumors, whether or not they're true or not, I don't know.
Me personally, don't know, but from what I've heard, yeah.
So
It's
I have no idea
Rory.
what he actually builds or not.
Well, currently, I think he's into logging with Joe Gonzalez.
Yeah, I jumped down Joe's shit when I first started modding because I wanted. A grass texture from Opie, and I, you know, because I don't know what Facebook did, but I feel like just because of Farm Sim and all of us trying to get a hold of each other on Messenger, I think they made it so like you could get message requests a little easier now or something. So I feel like, but
Oh yeah, it used
I
to be
commented
like
on
hard
it was
to
so
get
hard,
message requests.
yeah, because you'd have to like go in there and now you get a notification for it if you have Messenger, which
Which
is
it should
nice
have been like
because,
that a long time ago, honestly,
yeah.
but
But I feel like it's just because of Farm Sim. I know it's not, but it'd be fun to, it's fun to think that. Why do you keep stopping? All right, so I'm gonna just drive this combine. So out of all the stuff that he does, whether or not you know he builds it or not, he's got some good mods, and I don't think he's probably had somebody else build them all. That he couldn't make an ad strip. I thought that was kind of interesting.
I can't make an ad strip though.
It's so easy.
I can make an ad strip, but like actually making custom logos like you do, I can't.
Yeah. The ideas are the hardest part for me. If I could actually build, you know, like draw pictures and stuff like that, it would be a little bit easier, I think, because, you know, I can get an idea, and I can get all the pictures and stuff that I need off of Google. But when I get to start deleting the pixels and stuff like that, it gets really pixelated at some points, and it's hard to make look really good. And his even has the one I sent to him. I try to do my best work to leave an impression, hopefully, on him and those guys at Canadian Farming. And it's still it's kind of pixelated around the edges and stuff. My logos all look pretty good, and I think I got most of the pixels out of yours, Zach, but it's tough because it gets so small, and
Yeah.
then if you zoom out, you can see just the right, you know, just the right spot, you can see them. But like he didn't even know you know what programs to use or anything, which I just thought was funny.
Yeah.
He was nice. He was nice. He asked nicely and everything. So I was like, yeah, sure, I can help you, whatever. And I did that for him. And on a note on the private mod stuff, it's I think. A lot. Another reason why a lot of modders keep their stuff private is because they just get tired of being asked over and over again. You know, it's like when I post a picture somewhere and I get asked, "What? I don't know." I sent you a screenshot. It was like three or four in one screenshot with of people asking what map it was. When 2 comments earlier, I told somebody what map it was. And, like, people continue to ask. That is one of the most annoying things ever. Is when people can you ask the same question over and over again.
Yep.
Which, you know, it just got to be. I can't imagine what it's like for Lindbergh and Random and even Ty. Ty's got, you know, a couple thousand subscribers on his YouTube channel. And, you know, he's part of Canadian FM Farming. And they've got how many thousands of people like their page. Being asked, you know, is this going to be released? You know, how are you coming on this over and over again would just get old by having, you know, hundreds of people do it.
So I know you and I talked about this earlier, but I want to bring it up on video. The new Central Valley map.
Yeah.
And we are both on the same page that we both think, well, I personally think it's just kind of boring.
Yeah, it's it's an edit of Goldcrest is what it is. That's why it's called Central Valley, hence the valley part. It's a random Sparks map, so it's good. You know, he did a good job placing stuff.
Yeah, it's very well put together.
But in another sense,
for the amount of hype that was going around the map, I just think it's a little bit boring for how hyped up it was.
Yeah, I agree. I looked around at GE, and there's not even a town in it or anything like that. It's the farm, like 3 cell points and fields. Which, I mean, this map doesn't have a quote-unquote town. It's got 1 strip that's got, you know, a couple things, but it's better than just nothing.
Yeah.
And I think as we progress, I mean, his Lincoln Creek map obviously is head and shoulders above of Goldcrest or of Central Valley. And part of it is we haven't, I don't know of anybody that's actually figured out the texturing of maps, because textures from 15 won't work in 17, which is weird
maybe
because
the PV Rivers guy, I can't remember his name.
Oh yeah. I was just watching a video the other day.
He always seems to like be on the forefront of figuring out what Giants messed up.
Yeah. And that's one thing they did mess up, because these textures, regular textures, are terrible. This map actually has, I put new textures in it for the grass. It's, as you can see, it doesn't have flowers anymore, and it's not like tall. It's just brush grass there.
Looks
and better. I have new bales. I have the photorealistic bales, which I don't think Zach can see because it's part of my path folders. I don't know if you have them or not, but
I need to
like
get
my bales look different than his bales would. Our screens would look different there. But that's really all I have. The texture pack that the grass happened, texture came with.
What happened was, I think I was modding, and I like wasn't paying attention to what was coming out for some of the stuff, and I think I missed some stuff. So.
Yeah, I had to go back through all that stuff because, as you remember, I was really late to the 17 party.
Oh, yeah, you were.
Because I got Battlefield 1 and played that for like 2 months straight on my PS4, and I didn't even turn on my PC for quite a while. And then I got on my PC, and my drivers were out of date, my Java needed updated, my computer needed updated, you know, just the Windows needed updated. So I was really late to the 17 party, so getting all the mods and stuff. I can't imagine what it's going to be like for Kraft and Rory, those guys that are still playing 15, that don't even have 17 yet.
Brain dead.
Rory, he still doesn't have 17?
He has it, he just doesn't play it.
Oh, he just, say he made his 15, Anhydrous so. Toolbars.
Someone else did those.
Oh, he released them.
Yeah, he put them on AEM, but I think Midnight Modding did the conversion.
Oh, okay. Okay. Whatever.
I will that 5-fold that he's working on does look pretty nice.
Oh, I can't wait for that, because those 3-folds are 2-fold, does it be? It's not anything wrong with the mod itself. They're just too small.
Yeah.
And it takes too long. Oh, and the single anhydrous tanks still do that. I don't know if you noticed in 15, but like, if you get going fast enough, they'll like fly into the ground and fly out and bounce all over the place.
Oh, they still do that?
Yeah, they still do. Which I just use, I don't use those in the field. I use the triple anhydrous in the field. Those are just my transport tanks, but so at least the ground response doesn't affect them.
Yeah.
Back to the textures though, these regular in-game textures are not, I mean, they're good textures. I mean, you know, they look good, but when you're used to the stuff that we had in 15 towards the tail end there, these are absolute trash. This soybean texture is pretty good, though. I do like the soybean texture.
I'll say this. Not very many people know this, and Sean, I don't even know if you know this. I had a custom, fully custom Kansas-Nebraska border map that I did for Justin.
I was part of that.
Okay, so you did know about it. I don't know if you... Yeah. Did you ever play it?
Well, see, the thing is when I did that map, I was just getting into the modding community, and I really didn't know you yet. I knew Justin.
Okay.
And I had this guy put alfalfa in it, and he fucked it up. It didn't work. Because that's how Justin and I got... What's that?
I don't think you played mine then.
No, I never played yours, I don't think.
Okay, because mine had, it had alfalfa. It might have had clover. It had corn too. Corn.
You know what? Justin sent me that. And I never played it because by that time I was playing County Line or something like that.
Oh, yeah.
And so I never played it, but I have it. Or I had it. I probably don't have it anymore. But I had it. And he might have sent you did it have, a CPS and stuff in it?
It didn't have CPS. I think it had, a declab and then just a in-game elevator.
I don't know. I put a CPS in mine and a new storage spaces and stuff like that. I put all animation map trigger doors or buildings on it.
Yep, mine did too, yeah.
Yeah. So if you might have gotten an early version of mine or something like that. I might not have put CPS because that's how Justin and I got to be friends, was through that map. Because I'd posted pictures on it and he asked me what map and I said that map, you know, my Kansas-Nebraska edit. And just went from there.
I don't even think this one has pictures out of it. I don't think Justin and I really took pictures of it even.
Yeah.
It was, honestly, that map is the best single player map, I'd say.
Oh, it is. I played hours on that map for hours and hours. But I ran into some issues because, like I said, I was still new to the whole modding. So I couldn't, you know, I could get into the log and, you know, but I couldn't tell you what anything meant. I finally did figure out I had issues with soil mod conflicts and stuff like that, conflicts, and I got those all ironed out. But, yeah. I loved that map, and I actually have the terrain converted from it, so if you ever get the itch to start mapping again, I have the terrain and everything converted over. It just needs buildings placed and fields made.
But I have a different Holstran modding map I want to do.
What's it going to be?
I had someone, and he asked me not to say his name. I'll tell you later, but he asked me not to say his name publicly, so I'll respect that. Build me a smaller map, kind of some strip farming stuff.
Oh, yeah? I think I know who you're talking about, because it might have been the person that converted this for me.
Yeah, it might be, because he's not bad at modding. But he's not very well liked in the community by a lot of the people. So he just doesn't want people to know that he's doing stuff.
Oh, that might not be who I'm talking about then. The guy I'm talking about is in FuckD, so, and he's actually pretty publicly known because he just put out a big project.
Yeah, it's not him. The guy I'm talking about just got into FuckD.
Oh.
He's not a bad person, but he'll just definitely call people in the community out when he sees it fit. So, and people don't like him for that.
Oh, is he with Justin and I, you know, in our small little group there?
Nope.
No, he's not? Okay, then nope. Not who I was thinking of. Not Dan.
He called out, who just had their 7R leaked?
I don't know. I heard about that, but I never got involved in it because have no idea whose it was. There's like 3 or 4 7Rs out there. They're all Europeans, so.
He called them out because they said that they were done, but they're still sharing pictures. He's like, well, if you're done, then I guess we can all unfollow you on Facebook then, right?
Oh, was that, is that Wayne who got called out or something like that? Wayne Dunn or something?
Maybe.
I don't know. Because there's been quite a few people who have said that they're done with Farming Simulator.
But honestly, the way I look at it is if you say that you're done modding, then you can close up your Facebook page.
Yeah.
If you're going to keep your Facebook page around to be a dick and just share private photos, well, there's a bunch of groups for that.
Yep. I'm in quite a few of those, but that's because it's actually kind of fun to rub, like this map, for example. I kind of rubbed that in the face of a few people because they really like the buildings and stuff that I have set up over there. But it's kind of fun to run private mods, rub private mods in private modder spaces.
Oh yeah.
Or my GMC that I my farm truck there, that's got, you know, it's gray with the black, you know, all that black trim and stuff like that. There's quite a few of them, those guys that were pretty interested in it. But it's just an edit. The actual truck is, it's released. You know, I said from the very beginning of my series that most of the stuff that I edit that is quote unquote private, just because it's got my logo and stuff on it, and I like to be original. I don't want everybody having the truck that I have. Even the stuff that I released in 15, my version is different from everybody else's version. Just because, you know, if everybody has, you know, for example, when we release our Silverado, if everybody has a red Silverado with all those features, then it's just kind of boring. So my version will likely be a different color pickup, at least, and stuff like that. I mean, I'll have logos and stuff all over it. Releasing also takes time to, you know, uploading your files and stuff like that. And, you know, I pay $100 a year for Dropbox.
You pay for your Dropbox?
Yeah, you have to. You can't get it for free.
How much? $100 a year. Get with that.
I honestly don't know. I'm not anywhere near full, and I've got, you know, quite a few gigabytes worth of stuff in there.
Because I'm still using free Google Drive.
Yeah, I've thought about using Google Drive, but I don't know.
I think the base that you get is bigger for free.
Oh yeah.
And I guess I still have my 15 mods and stuff all on there.
Yeah, I've thought about killing the links for my 15 mods, but
I'll say it's probably going to happen to mine soon, just because I want the space back.
When I get into releasing stuff for 17, I'll probably start killing links for my 15 mods. But
if you haven't gotten the stuff by now, it's like you're probably not going to get it.
That stuff's been out for 6 or 7 months.
Yeah.
You know, and stuff does happen. You know, like me, I clear my downloads every once in a while, just completely clear out my downloads. So that way, you know, because it slows down your computer and stuff like that. So I clear those out, and sometimes I'm an idiot sometimes, and I will like delete stuff on accident. I'll put stuff in the trash can, and I won't be able to find it.
Oh yeah, I totally did that the other day. A friend asked me to mod something, and I downloaded it when I was rushed, and then I cleaned my downloads folder and forgot about it.
Yep. I wish I could just build simple stuff in Blender, so that way I didn't have to ask you for like that Bradford bed, for example. Like.
Oh yeah, I never actually started on that.
That's all right. It's not a big deal. It's just gonna be my bale truck more than likely. But like that, it shouldn't be hard to build because it's basically a square with a trapezoid on top of it.
Yeah.
You know, and some, you know, little obviously little things for the wheels and, you know, a hitch plate and stuff like that. But you know, it's not like you're building a full truck or something like that, which would be really hard.
Had someone offer me $100 to build them a Ford pickup.
Really?
Yeah, I said no.
It's kind of a dangerous game getting paid for stuff too.
Okay, so the way that people are doing that, and I don't think a lot of people understand this. You can charge them for services, you can't charge them for mod. And there's a big difference in that. You can charge them to get the model made unscripted.
But you can't charge them for the model.
You can't charge them for the mod itself.
Yeah, I get it now. I guess that does make sense.
Yeah. So, and Giants has that written in their little deal that you can't charge for mod, but you can charge for services for the model.
One thing I do get a little tired of hearing from people is that, like, you know, all the people that are pissed off about Lindbergh and Random Sparks and those guys keeping all their stuff private is that, like, once it's in the game, it's property of Giants, therefore it should be released. It might be true. I don't know. I've never read Giants' licensing agreement because I don't have to.
It actually is true.
It is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Even if it is true, it's a bunch of bullshit. Like, that's just basically saying that because you bought the game, you're entitled to what everybody else puts time and effort into. And Giants may think that, but when they start to do something about it is when I would start caring about it.
I don't know for sure, but I'd say that those JCB skid steers are really close to the 15 ones.
Yeah, they are.
So I think it comes down to something like that.
Yeah, I think Giants doesn't really care. I think what Giants meant by that is it's their property and they have the right to do whatever they want to it. So, for example, Giants could essentially take, you know, some of Lindbergh's stuff, for example. Like, they could take his precious Cat Challenger, and they basically did. And in-game it's, you know, or input the exact same thing in, you know, they could take it from his folder and put it in-game, is what they're saying. I don't think it's really meant to be, like, they have to release it. It's more meant that they can if they want to. It's theirs to release.
I don't use that one a lot, but the only person I really use that against was Polygonish.
Oh, yeah.
Once, because he was saying, well, you can't share the mod because it's the same thing. And I said, well, no, it's not the same thing because it's a different format now, you know, but...
Yeah.
Honestly, I'm not a law lawyer. I don't know who's right, who's wrong, but...
Yeah. I don't really care. Like I said, unless Giant starts enforcing it, it's not my problem. You know, that's the problem with the, you know, the way things work, is that... you can't just... I guess what I'm saying is nobody in this game is entitled to anything. Just because... like that post that I read earlier from that guy that didn't speak English. Just because you bought the game, or no matter how much you paid for the game, on what platform you paid for it, does not mean that you deserve anything that anybody else makes. That's like saying that if you bought a 1967 Camaro, you're entitled to the exact same Camaro that somebody put $100,000 and 100 hours of work to make it go fast and make it look really cool. I don't think anybody, you know, very few people would think that they were entitled to have that.
But for some reason, when it's a game,
yep,
some people
when it's
do.
A game, yeah.
And
because,
you know, I do think private mods do get a bit annoying from time to time, but
they do.
There's definitely a reason why people do it, and
like,
I'll say Farming Simulator is, out of all the games I play, is the worst one for private mods.
Yeah, we were just talking about this earlier before we got recording, where we were setting stuff up and making sure we had all our mods and stuff. About GTA 5, I was playing for a while LSPDFR, which is a police mod for the game, where you basically become a police officer, and it's really in depth. You know, the modders in the community, there is private mods, but it's not like the farms community. They don't show them off. They're not like the modders in this game. There's stuff that is absolutely, positively crazy in depth to think, and modding GTA 5 is really hard. I think modding in this game, I mean, it's not hard, but it is hard. And this game is hard. GTA 5 makes this game look like 1+1. It really does. I heard passenger script is going to start to be a thing in this game, too.
It already is.
It already is. I guess I did know there was a couple mods that have it. I know Lindbergh was experimenting with it in 15. I need to watch that thing. I think he had his pickups working with passenger script or something like that. What else do I need to buy? I need to buy a cultivator.
Yeah, I just realized we don't exactly... What do we have for that? Oh, the accelerator.
And Lindbergh's cultivator. I'll probably buy this one.
Who did the accelerator? Because actually, I don't know.
No idea. I bought Lindbergh's, though, because I think it has a little less horsepower requirements. And we need to sell that rodeo, the pickup.
We got to keep it.
You want to keep it? Okay, we'll keep
it. It's like the classic, you know?
Oh, all right, we'll keep it. I just don't like it because it's so undersized.
Right.
Like, I'm going to go find my pickup and stick it right next to it. It's so undersized.
I really want to get the accelerator, but I think I should wait until a little bit later.
There's my pickup. Like, this pickup is almost perfect size compared to the person in-game. Go drive it next to this lizard pickup, the in-game pickup, and it's like a toy car. It's like a toy. It's like my wheels on this are almost as tall as the bed. Like, I think, yeah, you're taller than the pickup is.
Yeah.
That's not normal, especially for a farm truck.
Like a real farm truck or a Southern Farming farm truck?
You mean a Southern Modding farm truck?
Yeah, Southern Modding.
Yeah. Those aren't farm trucks, those are...
Those are show trucks.
Yeah, those are million-dollar ranch trucks that... Well, not... Yeah. Well, the ranch is worth millions of dollars. The trucks are $60,000, $70,000, $80,000 trucks. But to each their own. I mean, I play it differently than some people. Some people like to have huge, big farms. And I said in my very first video, I mean, this game is meant to... It was built to be able to be modded and stuff like that for that reason. Is that... So there can be people, like, that want to... You know, there's people in... Some of the groups that we're in, Zach and I are in, that have Model A's and like 2-row corn choppers, and they take on fields of the size of the fields that we just 40-foot have, and that's what they like to do, and there's nothing wrong with that, and there's nothing wrong with the people that like the squad that want to screw around and just have fun. You know, that's the point of this game, is to have fun. There are some people, some of the YouTubers, and I have no problem calling them out by name. I can't think of his name. Now I completely lost it. I don't know.
You're going to call him out? You can't remember?
Yeah, I rant about this guy all the time. damn it. What is it? Not Phoenix Feather. Phoenix isn't bad. It's like Phoenix.
These fertilizer tanks, the Cargill ones, those are liquid, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Just liquid?
Yes. Offspring Gaming. That's who it is. Offspring. The reason I don't like him is the stuff that he does is so... It takes away from the integrity of the game. Like, he will pull, like, bulldozers that would need, you know, some of the heavy haul stuff that Eric's building right now, that would need those, and he's pulling them on a PJ trailer. He's just loading them up and pulling them with a PJ trailer. I'm like... Why?
Well, if your trailer can't do that, maybe you should buy a different trailer.
Yeah, I guess. But But that's why I don't like him. That's, you know, that's the only reason. It's not that, you know, I don't know him as a person or anything like that. And he released some stuff for 15 that I heard was not very good, and he paraded it around and made a big deal out of it, kind of like Lindbergh did, to a smaller extent, and I wasn't okay with that. I get tired of people who, if you're gonna build a mod and make it private, fine, but don't act like it's the best thing in the world, release it, and it turns out to be shit. That's my 2 cents worth.
Yep.
Did I put my Great Plains away? I don't think I did.
I haven't even bought a cedar yet.
Oh, I gotta put my mower away. Oh, I gotta put my old shed up too. You gotta check this thing out. This thing is absolute dope. It's the greatest thing ever. It's just this
That
little
old
tiny shed.
shed.
Yes, yeah, it's just the coolest little thing. It's right by my hay shed now. And it fits this mower absolutely perfectly. Which this mower is the loudest thing on the planet.
Oh.
It's right by my hay shed on at the hay field that I have, or that's going to be my hay field.
First, I gotta
There's
figure out
a
which one's your hay
there.
field.
It's the little tiny garage shed that's across. I'm texting and driving.
See, that's why you don't text and drive.
Yeah.
Tell your girlfriend you're filming for YouTube right now.
Yeah. She might think it's a little stupid. I don't know. She plays Sims though, so I can't. I don't know.
See, now you just got her to play Farming Sim too.
Yeah. I don't know if her computer could even run this game. I think it could barely run Sims and. No, that's what I was thinking is funny. When I first was shopping for a PC, I have a cousin that builds them, and I was talking to him about it, and I was like, you know, I really don't want to spend a whole lot of money because I'm just playing Farm Sim, and he didn't end up building me when I bought a pre-built, and I got it, and I was like, oh my God, this game is so hard on computers.
Yep.
Isn't this more loud though?
Yeah, it actually is. I'm more just following you. Oh, that shit.
Yeah, it thinks so cool. It's got a little light in it too that turns on. Yeah, somebody retextured this thing to be a John Deere.
Yeah, I saw that.
It's pretty cool looking. I like it. I like the idea. I don't want to copy him though, so I'd probably find a New Holland if I were to retexture it. Look at that. It's just so perfect. It makes really nice windrows too. It's perfect. It puts Wessel's W260 to shame. More than half the price, like almost like 9/8 the price. This thing's cost like 3 grand.
But I want the
And his
W260.
Yeah, that thing's like
Did you ever use mine that I
$200,000.
did?
I don't know.
It
Was
had
it for
some
15 or
couple errors in it.
17?
17.
I don't know. I just got this one off of a public site, so I have no idea. Did you get the HX15 to work? I couldn't get it to work.
I have one.
It would never mow for me.
Yeah.
I got it from our Dropbox too. It would never mow for me.
I might have a different one. I don't know where I got it from, but I have a different one because it does work for me.
Yeah, it wouldn't mow for me. So I just scrapped it. I mean, it was just a brush hog mower, and you know, so.
Do you know the one thing that always bothered me about this auger?
What's that?
How close these wheels are together.
Wait, which augur are we talking about?
The Farm King?
Oh. I don't
Like
know, I haven't looked
even
at
the
it.
one from the Augur pack in 15. It's the same
Oh.
model, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. You know, I think 17, when those get converted into 17 and, you know, everything, it gets set up right, it's going to be so much better because in 15, there wasn't really, like, the placeable silos were public, but they weren't great. You know, the ones that the private versions that people had were a lot better.
Yeah.
And they actually worked right. And the public versions worked, but they didn't work great. So I saw when 17 first came out, Lindbergh had a Meridian auger that he was dumping from the ground into his silo,
Oh yeah, I saw that.
into the pit of his silo. I was like, what are you doing?
Oh, by the way, this pickup I'm currently gonna pick up in the store. This is our pickup that we're working on together.
Which version do you have? Do you have the one that I sent you, or do you have the latest version?
I
Because I
have the
have
one that
version
you
on.
sent me, so it's not the latest one.
It's version 11, so it still has that god-awful semi-plate in it, I think.
It might, yeah. Oh well.
But that's all we had until Zach graciously made us a good fifth wheel plate. Oh crap, wrong door. Which did
Wrong
look really
hole.
good. It just had some attached joint. I don't know. What was wrong with the attached joint?
Still haven't figured it out. I gotta
You
mess
still
with the
haven't figured it
numbers.
out.
That's like, okay. That's the problem, is I don't fully know what these numbers mean. So you
Yeah,
spend
same.
time making a small change and then going back in game and testing it.
Yeah. That was like me when I was, because, I don't know, I messaged Zach one day and I was like, all right, I think I want to try to figure out these configurations and stuff like that, because it, you know, it's a really good idea and it can be really great. And so a couple days passed and I messaged him. I was like, I figured out design configurations. Or no, I figured out attach joint configurations first. And I get in there and I was like, oh, maybe not. It's not working. Because I had no idea what anything means. I was just copying and pasting and fixing the indexes. It took me almost a year to figure out what the indexes meant. From fifth, you know, from 15 to now, it took me all that time to figure out node index, stuff like that, what all that was.
Yep. That's
That's
a
modding
big
for
thing.
you.
That's honestly where I 9 times out of 10, the problems that I find people have are they don't close their lines in the XML.
Yeah, I had that problem a lot. That was so frustrating to
Yeah.
me.
Or they delete something in GE and mess up all the indexes.
Yep. Now I gotta find my cultivator here and fix it.
Yeah, you gotta dig that out of the ground.
Yeah, I'm gonna reset it once. Oh, I don't have reset.
You should. I thought I
Oh,
gave
yeah.
you. Yeah.
I think I can hook to it now. It said I didn't have permission, though. I don't know why I can. Where did my tractor go?
What tractor
But,
do you pull that with?
I'm not sure if my 8520 is gonna have enough horsepower for it. I'm gonna hope it does. If not, I might sell my 8020 and grab an 8530. It needs 350 horsepower, and I have 325. It might pull it. It might.
It always like seems too big for it to me.
Yeah, I feel like 350 horsepower is a little much for that, but I know Lindbergh built that off specs. Off real specs, so I don't know.
Well, I can't buy the accelerator anyways because it needs
Why?
400 and I can't afford a 9R yet. I think
Oh.
that's really the only thing that we have that big. Oh, we have the New Holland.
You need 400 horsepower? Hang on. Hang on. How much money do you have?
1.3 million and some corn in the bin.
You could buy the 9RT for 434,542 and have just enough horsepower for it. Actually, 60 more than you need. The only problem is it's an RT, so it's a tracked one, and so it's they're kind of tough to drive, to be completely honest.
I think I'm gonna just wait until I can sell some crop.
Yeah.
Because I still need to buy a seeder and a planter.
Yeah, I haven't decided what I'm going to do for the planter yet, if I'm going to actually buy it or if I'm just going to lease it. And yeah, this is how you dig stuff out of the ground, guys. You unfold it while you hook to it, and it goes all kind of wacky and looks pretty cool, actually. But yep, and there we go. We are dug out of the ground there. The DB60, unfortunately, guys, does not work so easy. You physically have to dig that out of the ground with forklifts, or not fork with a bit with pallet forks, and
You should have cripples on that.
should have what on it?
You should have
Triples on
cripples
it?
on it.
When I do secondary tillage, I'll probably put triples on it. And it's pulling this just fine. I mean, we're going 32 and it's not even flinching. So if I had triples and I get a big front weight for this, it'll probably be okay. Oh, the environment XML on this,
Yeah.
it's from the interior, so it looks pretty good. I actually messaged Sirius and asked him if he'd send it to me. There's one in the interior that's the one basically is like his private version. So I was like, okay, I will download and I will extract. Because I had no intentions of what? Flock. Oh, that's what I did. I had no intention of playing the interior because I don't like logging. It's hard.
Time consuming.
Yeah. I guess, I don't know, with the development of auto like that, that 17 is really made simple, I guess, because there's auto load trailers everywhere now. It might not be so bad, but I don't know. The yields, the amount of money that you get is a little unrealistic, so I don't care to do that. And there's not a whole lot of logging that goes on in Indiana or Nebraska for that matter. So all of our trees were planted. None of them grow naturally. Like, I don't know, have you ever been in Nebraska, Zach?
I've been through it going to Kansas.
Yeah, it's
I'm
a
gonna hit a
pretty
tree.
terrible place. No, I'm not. It's a pretty terrible place, actually. But you know how in Elkhorn River Bottoms, how both farms are surrounded by those big evergreens?
Yeah.
That's actually legit. Like, it's a wind barrier, is what it is. And they were planted in the 1930s during the Great Depression and the Dust Bowls. That's why
Oh.
we have those. And that's why we're the Arbor Day capital of the world, or something like that. The creators of Arbor Day, something like that. I guess I can buy my dry fertilizer spreader now. My DN. I don't know if I should buy the DN or if I should just buy an R4045. 4045.
Ooh, choices.
Yeah, the 4045 is 25,000, 250,000, but I can get a sprayer for it and a fertilizer spreader. Because I'm probably gonna buy the. No, because I'll probably rent the Patriot for my. Oh. Because if I'm gonna buy the 4045, then I should. There's no sense in me buying the DN because I can just get the spreader body for this.
I
Tough.
personally like the 4045, but
Yeah.
it's the cost really of buying it all.
The good thing is with that mower, I don't need a windrower because
Yeah.
I just baled wet grass. It doesn't matter to me because I'm not making, you know, moo chow. So we have two Degelmans. Oh, did you put your Degelman in here?
I must have.
Is yours the one that says push harder?
I guess I'll have to go look at the store image.
Oh no, I bet this came from.
Oh yeah, okay, the one that says push harder would be for the
Yeah,
9R.
the 9R. I need to buy a fuel trailer. Black with silver rim. Now we get our fuel trailer. I got that Chieftain fuel trailer off the mod hub.
Yeah.
That thing is so tiny.
Right.
Yeah, I was because I was gonna use it, and I was like, all right, this will be cool.
No, it's not. I'm gonna buy a big weight, a big AGCO weight, and we're gonna make it green. I don't know which green to go with, though. We'll go with that green. I don't know. Yeah, like this is how serious like John Deere is. Like John Deere green isn't even in the game. There's all kinds of different greens, but John Deere green is not one of them.
Yep. I do have the hex code for what's close to it. What should be close to it. That's the problem, is a lot of
Oh,
these people
you got
don't
a planter.
actually. Yeah, my planter's there. I'm gonna have to dig it out of the ground.
Yeah. I'll let you do that on camera. I'm not gonna do it on camera.
Who says I was doing it on camera?
I have no idea. Are you still recording or are you done?
I am still recording currently.
Same.
I'm gonna be done here soon.
Yeah. Or else this is gonna take forever to upload. Open the front arm
Oh yeah,
there.
we are
That's right.
almost at 2 hours.
Yeah, it's gonna take forever to upload, but that's alright.
Yeah, I'll probably just wait and go grab that out of my save game.
Yeah, I should do that. Because my planter will be in the right spot if I do that. I just put that in my vehicle's XML.
Yeah,
With
if
the
you
whole line.
grab me that XML line, I can put it in the save game.
You'll just have to put it in a different spot than mine. Because mine will be in my shed. So if I put mine in there, yours can't be on top of it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll
You
just
just
move
find those.
mine manually, and then I can input yours in the
Okay.
line.
Okay. Works.
It's not cheating. If you guys have used these DB60s,
Yeah,
they're a bitch to move.
it would probably take you 20 minutes to, you know,
Yeah.
realistically it'd take you like 20 minutes to take that thing out.
You need like two pieces of equipment to
Yep.
get it.
Because you gotta rent a wheel loader or buy a wheel loader to dig it out because it's the only thing that's heavy enough to get it out of the ground, and then you have to be able to hook it up to something. Was I coming again? I was going to get my pickup. And then you have to be able to hook it up to something, and then you have to pull it out. You have to unfold it and pull it out, and then refold it to transport it. So it takes quite a while.
And if you guys have
Really
ever
annoying.
accidentally unhooked them while they're unfolded, that's when you
Is it
just
synced
have to
back in? I
replace them.
haven't done that. I
You
haven't
haven't?
actually.
Oh no,
No, I haven't.
the hitch goes up in the air just because of how it's weighted.
Really?
Yeah, and you can't get it down.
Kevin did a good job fixing it though, because it was absolutely useless in
Yeah.
6 and 15. It was useless.
I'll get my tractor to the store at least, and then I'll probably be done.
Yep, I'm gonna take this back to them. I'm gonna fill it up and take it, put it away. And I need to add the drop hitch from our Silverado onto this thing so that way I can. Okay, I'm gonna go show these. Is the Silverado at your farm?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna go show it to those guys too. Because the people in my channel have not seen said pickup yet, because they've seen the store image of it, but they have not seen it in game.
For some reason, I don't know what I was doing, but it doesn't have any of the stuff in
What do you mean?
it. I bought it pretty much uncustomized.
Oh, well,
It's
that's
pretty
right.
much
The
a base.
customization options are the ranch hand and the tailgate right now. So,
Yeah.
oh, that's sweet. That's still filling, so I can just leave that there. Roll. Oh, the giant still didn't fix the chrome showing up like light in the dark. Which drives me
Right.
nuts. Which drives me nuts. It's so sad. I like the sound of this pickup though. I took it off of my channel truck 15. Took the sounds off the channel truck 15 and put it on this. They sound pretty good. It's a little loud, but it's all right. Nothing on truck.
It'd be cool if we could figure out different sounds for a motor configuration.
I heard there was somebody working on it because they released a pickup that had a couple different motor options, and they wanted to put new sounds with it, and they hadn't figured it out yet. I did figure out how we could do, if we ever decide to do, or either of us ever want to, just for our own personal use. There is a way that I to get. Remember how Adam from Fucked wanted the just the fifth wheel ball instead of the ball hitch? You can put a separate attacher joint like configurations. Because there's the configuration and there's each configuration. Well, you could put a separate joint in there, a separate attacher joint configurations, and then inside that put the ball, and then the other attacher joint configurations, you can put the hitch or the fifth wheel hitch.
Yeah, 'cause I made a ball with it too.
Yep. Which I took out because I couldn't use it. So, all right. So this is a drop hitch that I put on there. It does work and everything. It's just not movable.
Yeah, so essentially the one that we have is mouse controllable, up and down.
It's up and down, and it looks way different than this. The down though is the same height, actually, I think.
Yeah, it's about the same size.
There's a tailgate that goes here. It's a fifth wheel tailgate that goes there. And there's a ranch hand actually on my truck. It's this ranch hand here that will go on there. That you can put on there.
Then a
The version that,
toolbox.
yep, the version that we have, or the version that's not in here, has the option for a toolbox, the option for a fuel tank that is not fillable. We tried to get it fillable, but we
No,
couldn't
so
figure it
far
out.
we haven't got it yet.
Yeah, it
It
has
is
not been
a
figured out.
fuel trigger, but it's not a refillable like the trailer.
Yep, three of us have tried it. I've tried it, Zach has tried it, and the scripting genius Eric tried it, I believe. He did try it, right?
Yeah, well, he kind of
Or
looked
he
at
made
it.
it look a bit slow, slightly, but three people have tried it and have all failed. Don't know why you would, I've stolen scripts from just about everything there is, and I don't know. I have no idea why it doesn't work. But it doesn't, so that's fine. It was not a hill that we were going to die on, so we just kind of left it. And then it's got the brackets will stay, but the fifth wheel plate comes on and off as an option. And I think that's all we put on there, but that's actually quite a lot of stuff considering we started out not even knowing how to put a configuration in.
Yeah.
So it's not a bad little truck. I like that. I like the bin set up there.
Yeah, actually, it's the same one. I just moved one thing around.
Did you take this from Elkhorn?
No, this is from this map.
Oh, it's from this map?
Yeah, I was too lazy to bring something else in, honestly.
Yeah, I tried taking the one from Elkhorn and putting it on Westbridge, and it didn't work because
Hey,
the.
come over here quick. And then you can turn that on.
What do you do? Open door. I got an open door option.
Yeah, I hid the
Oh.
visibility of the doors.
That. Okay.
Yeah. But then you can see your you can see your fill
That's
levels
fine.
and stuff here for it.
That's nice. We would have both done placeable silos, except I like my augers for now.
Yeah.
We might, I might pretend take it into GE and delete the whole thing,
Yeah, you
delete that
really
set up
could
there.
because all it needs is the triggers.
And then no, just delete the whole setup there and act like I upgraded to a big bin setup type of thing,
Oh, yeah.
I
Right,
wish you
well.
could put viable objects in this in 17. I don't know if anybody's figured it out yet, but actually I was watching some of Lindbergh's old stuff. Because I was trying to figure out if he ever released stuff for 13. And in 15, at the very beginning, his Windchaser map actually has like viable objects and stuff in it. I didn't realize how in depth he went into the thing.
Weird.
Yeah. But yeah, I'll put bigger bin set up maybe later. And I tried
Honestly, this is
taking.
like just a little bit big for my setup, but
Yeah, it's big, but I mean, like, this is like the size of the bins that I sent you a picture of yesterday.
Yeah.
Those guys are like some of the biggest farmers in Nebraska, and they're out by where I live.
And if they do a lot of corn and stuff, then
they do a lot of corn. Like they're the biggest detasseling hires. Like they hire all the people that detassel for the most part. I like these Cargill tanks too. It took me for a while to find them. I didn't realize they were on AEM.
Yeah.
They're a little big for just, you know, a farm that would be the size of ours, but
they look nice. They're a little shiny, nice. But they look nice.
Yeah. They're better than these tanks here.
Yeah. Except for these do have a pretty good rusted texture.
Yep. They're just awkward because they have, you know, the logos on them. You know, as opposed to Cargill just has, you know, Cargill on it. Oh, I forgot to show you my sewing machine jigger back at my farm. It's pretty cool. Ooh, lag like crazy there. Ugh. So in this Lindbergh shit, actually is what it is, ironic. I took the seed boxes off of the seed tender, the 410 XLV that can't remember who released it. But Kevin Watts released, and I took the seed boxes, and I put them out, and then the trigger's right next to them.
Huh. There's no collision on them.
No, there's no collision on them, but the trigger's right next to them, so you, like, if you hit F5, it's right next to them, so. I didn't put collisions on them. I did a few... Did you ever look at the objects pack that you can get off of, like, the public sites, you know, that has all the objects on it? Basketball and basketball hoops.
Yeah.
It's a mess. If you import it into, like, your map you're working on, it's a mess. So I had to open it up just by itself and export all the stuff. I took the shop back and the toolbox and the bench and put it in there.
It's actually a nice bench.
Yeah. I was going to put an air compressor on it, but I forgot about the air compressor. And I had a tip trigger back in here for... This is where I was going to put my fertilizer, in this big door here. But I couldn't get the tip trigger to work right. They're still there. Everything just went through. You can see where they are. But, or maybe they're not in this one. I might have taken them out of this one.
Yeah, I don't see any.
Yeah, they're out of this one. They were there. It took me forever to get the tip collisions working right on this commodity barn, though. I had to add a... I painted in front of them, and then I raised... I moved the collisions in a little bit on this side so it didn't come through the back on the side. But if you walk back here and look, like, it's doesn't go all the way there, and it doesn't go all the way back, which isn't a big deal. But and I did it for this one because it's the only one I use.
All right, well, I need to probably sign off and go to bed.
Yep, same. So... Alright, this is going to end the video for me. It's going to end the video for Zach. We'll be back on again, you know, sometime. I don't know when. Just depends on when we're both free. So
sometime.
See you later, guys. Have a good one.